Hi guys, it's Blackie. Okay, let's do a real quick tip or trick. Let's talk about whenever we're going to be making a fuzzy stick. A fuzzy stick, as you know, is not a feather stick. We're not going for nice big long curls. We're just trying to rough it up where it'll catch a match and burn. A feather stick is very good straight wood that you can get those long paper thin curls. A fuzzy stick is what you got available and you can't quite make it work, but you can turn in. Now, how do you tell which is a good stick? Well, one, for making a fuzzy stick, I want it at least as big as my thumb in diameter, okay? Two, when I pick it up and I go to lightly bend it, is it just gonna snap in my hand? That's too soft, it ain't gonna work. It's gotta be able to take a little bit of a load. On a scale of 1 to 10, around a 4, you know. Anything more flexible than that, and it's too green. Anything that I just touch and it snaps, it's too soft, okay? Next, get off any surface stuff I can get off of it. Then you want to take your knife. I like to put it up against a tree like this. Take the knife and I'm going to start, come up about 4 to 6 inches from the bottom of it. And I'm going to start pushing and planing up like you do in a feather stick. Now notice sometimes they slice off. That's fine. Be sure to catch them. It's a good idea to have something underneath there to catch it. Now I'll do that until it's so thin, see, snaps off. That's what I want. I put that in a pile, I put that back up there, I turn over the other side, and I start doing again, just like that. Anywhere I can grab it, bite it, sometimes you hit a hard spot like that, roll it up. Not all the way down till it's so thin I can just pull it right quick. Snaps off just like that. Now I've taken one stick and I've just made two. I could probably make 6 or 7 like this. Now what that does is it creates surface area. So now I put those together. Okay, I go from a third one. This is old gnarly oak. Come on now. Sometimes you gotta take your thumb of your offhand and push it. Just like that. Come to the back side now. And see that one snapped off. Now from that one stick, I've created this. Look at all that surface area. Easy to catch a match, ain't it? Now that stick could be wet, and I can take it up off the ground, bang it up against a tree to knock off any excess water. Take my knife, strip off that wet bark. It's just gonna hold things up. And then I start doing that. I gnaw it down until it snaps off. Each time it snaps off, I just add it to the pile. Usually like, those shavings I drop off, make sure I'm catching them on something. Put something down there to catch them in, if possible. And then lay all of those real willy-nilly up there to be a dryer to catch a match, catch a piece of tinder or whatever ignited. That's the surface area I'm looking for to generate that quick flame. Those thin pieces right there will easily reach combustion quickly, and that's what we want. So, when to do a fuzzy stick? When it's been raining for 3 days and everything's wet, and the only dry tinder that you know of is in your haversack. Well, I still want to try to conserve that a little bit. So I'm going to gather up my wood, get everything to the place that I'm going to build my fire at, get my shelter up, get everything set. So that when I sit down and start making these, I'm not going to leave them exposed for long because moisture in the air can also affect you. I want to make them quickly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, snap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, snap. Make up a pile of them. Something at least that size of a, you know, cue ball right there. I'd prefer something the size of a softball if it was still pouring rain. so that when I stick a match in there, I stick the flame to it or whatever, it ignites and it just starts running, and I got multiple ignitions here. So I put it down, I have my other wood ready to go and my tinder above it. It starts quickly spreading and generating the fire that I want. But that's the trick, is these little, I used to call them when I was a kid, we called them fire darts, because it looked kind of like a dart that had a feather on the end and a pointy, because you'd shave them down. I watched them old men take pocket knives on wet days, and they'd pull a limb off of a cedar tree or something. They'd go shaving like that, and it would look like a dart when they got done with it. And they would stack them up in just a wad of them like that, take a match, put into it, and before you knew it, you had flame everywhere. Simple tip or trick. Hope you enjoyed it, guys. If you enjoyed this content, please hit that like and share. I'd really appreciate it. Till next time, guys, I'm Blackie wishing you safe journeys. Have a great day, guys.